don't know, he has an outreach ministry that extends itself to the communities and other churches. We started this ministry years ago, and the Lord has continued to allow the fire to ignite. So every first Friday, this church is full, y'all, with people from different churches. And if you get a chance, you ought to try to come out, because it's a blessing. And actually, say amen for sister, for Brother Steve. Brother Steve came out on the first Friday, and now he's a part of our church. Amen. I believe our sister said, amen.
Amen.
Amen. She came down on the first Friday. Hallelujah. We serve a good God, y'all. But I preach this message. I'm grateful. Fridays are a little raw because we're trying to attract sinners. And so that was the R-rated version. Hallelujah. Hey, y'all know me. I already is still under the holy blanket. Let me just get y'all straight. Hallelujah. Where he leads me, I will follow. Y'all hear it? All right, so we're going to recapture some of that, of what we shared. I want to acknowledge this great day, Palm Sunday, when Jesus came into Jerusalem. It was prime time. Many of you who understand the scriptures, especially the gospel, knows that he spent the majority of his time in the region of Galilee, but at the appointed time, when he purposed himself to go to Jerusalem to give his life, to suffer in a great way for every ugly, evil thing you and I have ever done. He died for you and he died for me. And now your sentence is life. You're not sentenced to death. Everything you've done wrong, every evil thing you've ever said, any form of sexual immorality, drunkenness, anything you've ever done is nailed to the cross. Jackie read some scriptures about a woman who was really out there. And I feel her heart because I know I drive y'all crazy with constantly thanking God for his mercy and grace in my life, but I'm grateful. I don't care if I say it every Sunday. I am grateful. Not just to be behind this pulpit, I'm grateful that I'm standing here alive today. But the devil had a hold of me, y'all. The devil was my father. Hallelujah. But Jesus brought the papers and said, I have adopted him. That's my son. Hallelujah. Who am I talking about? The song says, Satan had me bound, but Jesus lifted me.
Hallelujah.
Yes. No more chains. Hallelujah. How many are free today? And you know you're free. See, you didn't even know you were chained up back in the day, did you? You didn't even know you were bound, but when Jesus lifted you, all of a sudden you looked up and you said, I'm free!
Thank you.
I don't know who's in the house today and you struggle with, but I'm telling you, the God I serve has sent his spirit. The Holy Spirit dwells on the earth. And he is able, if you allow him to work, he'll cleanse you, clean you up, wipe you down, heal your mind, and give you that peace you've been looking for. He's worthy to be praised. We have here, again, getting back to the story. Come on, Holy Spirit, can I get back to the story here now? Hallelujah. There are three references in the New Testament where Jesus was anointed
with a costly burden. Deacon Jack read the one in Luke 7, and this woman was known as a sinner. We also see Mary, the sister of Martha, later on, and she anoints Jesus with this costly perfume. Matter of fact, it cost so much, they say it was worth a year's wages. So we see Mary now. Mary knew Jesus. The woman in Luke 7 did not, you know, she was known as a sinner, saved by grace. And the reason why I'm talking about her is because that's a picture of me. But Mary now knew him, but yet was so in love with him that she decided to make a great sacrifice. And some of us in the house, we've been walking with the Lord a long time, but there's still some things we haven't given him yet. Amen. 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 Why don't you start today? Hallelujah. Amen. Because that thing you holding on to now, sometimes we hold it on to something. Y'all ever see the picture of Jesus and he's before the little girl, and the little girl's got the little teddy bear, and the teddy bear's all beat up and chewed up, and she had chewed on and spit on it, and it's all messed up, and he's saying, "Give me that little teddy bear." And she don't want to give it up, and she can't see, but behind his back, he's got this huge, brand new teddy bear that he wants to give her. It's a picture of some of us. We holding on to stuff. Yes. We don't want to make the sacrifice. Yes. And he got a big teddy bear ready to hand you. Why don't you give up that thing that you think is all that? It's not all that. There is nothing I want to hold on to that's keeping me from my relationship with God. Amen. Yes. See Mary now. Mary makes a great sacrifice. And then in Matthew 26, we see a woman anointing Jesus' feet in the house of Simon the leper. And y'all know it was forbidden to be around a leper in biblical times. Jesus just went to those who we call outcasts. If we could look at a leper today, we could say maybe someone that has AIDS. People we don't want to be around. Jesus went to those places. Almighty God went to the worst of the worst. And here we, the church, we don't want to have nothing to do with folks that are hurt. Let's slip this in here. The Lord's been really speaking to me about this coming year. If the weather gets warm, we're going to get out of this church. And we're going to start reaching the lost. We're going to get creative. And we're going to start moving out of the boundaries of these walls.
Hallelujah.
That's what God has called us to do. We were having the missionary meeting, and Deacon Jackie was the one that came up with the idea, let's do this outreach through giving them clothes. And she said, I just feel we just need to be doing something. Hallelujah. That really hit my spirit, because saints, the time is short.
Yes.
And if you look at the season we're living in, huh? Y'all put your hope in the lighthouse. You better put your hope in the lighthouse. Amen. Well, I have a witness. Things can change like that. See, we got to recognize, church, we're not in control. He's in control. And there are things that we have no say in. We got no say in what's going on in Washington. I ain't got time to look at Washington. I'm looking at Jesus. He's the author and finisher of my faith. And I don't know about you, but he's at the right hand of power. He's got all the power in his hand. I'm worried about what I see. I'm too busy in my secret place talking to him every day. Thanking him for what he's about to do. Hallelujah. Jesus is in a leper's house. Hanging out. With a leper. Y'all not hear me today.
Amen.
But getting back to the woman we're discussing, the sinner. Most theologians believe that she was connected to the tax collectors and publicans. They had their own crew. Matter of fact, there were three different crews back then that I can think of right now. Y'all remember Barabbas? Who they chose to let go Imagine that. They chose a criminal over God. Almighty God is sitting there, who had done wonders. They saw him do things. They saw him heal their kids. They saw him raise the dead. Then they turned around and the devil had blinded them so much that they chose a criminal to let a criminal go over God. That's scary. And how much is the church blinded right now to the days we're living in? Some of these churches don't even talk about the fact that we are in the season of the coming of Christ. We're there right now. The devil is as busy as he can be because he don't have much time. And yet the church is blinded, just like they were blinded back when they chose Barabbas over Jesus. We need to be sober and alert. Our adversary's on the move. Hallelujah. We see here now so much deception, but they chose Barabbas over Jesus. And here these same folks, okay, don't understand. This man here doesn't understand. He sees this woman washing the feet of Jesus. She's so excited that her sins have been forgiven. She barges in on the meeting, and the Pharisee sits there and says, if he knew what this woman was, if he was a real prophet, he'd really know what she's about. This is the blindness I'm talking about. We cannot afford to be blind today. Are you struggling with understanding with your husband or your wife? You struggle with understanding with your child? We serve a God who's able to give you the wisdom. All you have to do is take time to talk to him. He spoke to me and he said, Mike, I understand you want to see me move in your kid's life, but be still and know that I'm God. Amen. Okay, Lord. Is that easy? Yeah, Mike, is that easy? Amen. Seek him while he may be found. Yes. This woman here, it is a good possibility that she was a product of the tax collectors. That was another group. Tax collectors were ruthless. Matthew was a tax collector. The one that wrote the book of Matthew, he was ruthless. They now were in charge of collecting taxes. You know, they are the IRS of the day. Except now, they were working against their own people. They would overtax their own people. They were ruthless. They were called the sinners. Matter of fact, if you were to look at Luke chapter 19, he wasn't necessarily a tax collector. He was one of the chief tax collectors. His name was Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus was so wealthy, and when Jesus was passing through that town, he called Zacchaeus out and said, I'm going to have dinner with you. They looked at Jesus like he was crazy. This group was evil. They were the ones, as a matter of fact, Zacchaeus was so evil, they eliminated him from being considered as the seed of Abraham. They said, you're not even a part of the seed of Abraham. That's how bad Zacchaeus was. And Jesus says, I'm going to have dinner with you. Tax collectors were wealthy. So what they hung out with? They hung out with prostitutes. They party 24/7. You know what I mean? There's some of us in the church today. We remember the day we party all night long. Maybe I'm the only one, but that's all right. I used to work with some guys. They would party all night long, and by 8, 9 in the morning, they'd have another brew in their hand. They'd have an 8 ball of crank. That's speed, y'all, in case y'all know what that is. And then you just go for days. And this is a picture of the task force. They party, sexual morality. They said, we don't care about the law of Moses. We don't care about the Jewish traditions. These boys were set apart. Y'all not hear me? Evil folks. And Jesus said, I'm going to have dinner with y'all. Almighty God died lost. I don't care what you've done, the blood of Jesus covers it. It's covered. It doesn't matter how deep your sin is, the blood covers that sin.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
This is why I'm so grateful, y'all. This is why I'm praising. Because everything I've done has been forgiven. Jesus goes and has dinner with them. And they look at him like he's crazy. I want y'all to pitch back now. That would be like me going into one of the most infested gang areas where there's, where, you know, with some of these gangs, y'all ever watch that movie, that show, American Gangster? And you see how some of these gangs just brutally take over a city, killing people. And causing a drug addiction and different things like that. It'd be like me going in those areas and saying, y'all, let's hang out. This is the God that we serve. He doesn't sit there and look down on you because of something you did. He sent his only begotten son because he loved us. God knows Jesus was tempted in every way that you and I, except he did not sin. He knows what we go through here. He knows we have an evil nature. He knows we're growing up in broken homes. He knows some of us have been molested. He knows some of us have been in homes where there's been abuse. He knows all. That's why he sent Jesus. We need to understand this story here. This woman now was a product. She was an outcast. And I don't care how bad someone is, there's always something in us that's crying out, I'm going to be free. At the age of 20 years old, with an afro this big, running around, I had plenty of ladies, I had to get high, I had all that stuff, going to the clubs, doing this, doing that, and you know what? I was empty.
Yes. Yeah.
I wasn't happy.
Hallelujah.
I wasn't happy at all. I was living a lie. But somebody on somewhere put my name in that prayer box.
Feeling a little bit better today. Amen.